Our next guest is the Queen of Broadway and an actual Disney princess.
Tiger in a cage can never see the sun. A beast beneath her stage.
To reaching new heights in Wicked. Idina Menzel has been the baddest witch in showbiz for almost three decades, but it was this chilling performance that has Idina forever frozen in the history books. And now she's set to rule the charts with her first ever pop album, aptly titled Drama Queen. Idina Menzel, welcome to the project.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
The album is called Drama Queen. I mean, how autobiographical is it?
Yeah, it's my reclaiming of the word, honestly. I kind of feel like, you know, obviously it gets a negative connotation a lot, and for me, you know, what could be better than someone that feels things deeply and boldly and is passionate and fiery and romantic and funny and very vulnerable and sensitive at times. So I'm owning that, and also, you know, I have played a queen or two in my life, so
yes,
I think I'm entitled to call it that.
Indeed you have. Are you a drama queen just in your day-to-day life, away from the stage, away from the screen?
I think I'm more of an introvert, and I like to cuddle up on my couch at home and hang out and go to my son's basketball games with my husband. And as a mom, I'm very, I can be a drama queen. I'm you know, worried for him all the time, and I love him, and he's a teenager, so I'm getting a lot of different emotions on that end, and I'm kind of a sensitive person, you know.
Oh, this raises something interesting. What kind of a parent are you when your kid's playing sport? Are you the one who yells at the ref? Are you the one who just sits there and gets nervous? What does it look like?
Well, you're talking to a parent that is also a singer who's known for a very wide range.
Yeah.
So I cheer,
yep.
And I am loud, and I can place it in a very good place that other people cannot. And I can do it and not lose my voice because I know how to do it technically.
So you can cut through the noise.
I can cut through, but then my son hears it, and then he gives me a stink eye, and I've been told that I cannot talk during foul shots.
Right.
I have strict instructions about when I am allowed to cheer and when I am not.
Okay, fair enough. Singing is obviously what you do. Do you remember the first time you decided or discovered that you loved it?
I sang at this, I guess I could say it was this talent show. I sang The Way We Were. It was a little day camp. I could hear that the other parents actually, because they come from, I grew up in Long Island, New York, which is a place where everyone has a very strong accent. And people would say, Stewie, your daughter's got a real talent there. You gotta get her some singing lessons.
Could you sing in that Long Island accent?
I did, like The Way We Were. I sing memories like the corners of my mind. I've since done a lot of speech and diction work at NYU, New York University, to work on getting rid of that. But a drink or two and it might come back, you know?
Ah, really?
Late at night.
Yeah, you can't help it.
Uh-huh.
Let's stay in New York though, because I want to talk a bit about Maureen in Rent. When you landed that role, what did you have in mind that your life would become?
I didn't have anything in mind other than my dream was to perform and sing and act for a living. I didn't know it would become what it did become and essentially changed my life forever. But it wasn't until 6-7 years later that that Wicked happened. So in that time, I was still having to kind of humble myself and, you know, pound the pavement and try to get work and audition. And so I think because of my life, my career has ebbed and flowed and has highs and lows, I think that it at least has taught me to not take things for granted.
The other big show that you mentioned is Wicked. And I mean, it's what a behemoth that is. I think it's actually coming back to Sydney here in Australia again very soon.
I think it is.
What would you say is the most lasting effect that that role's had in your life?
It was huge. You know, it's just so interesting how I feel really lucky that certain roles come at different times in your life when you actually need the character to teach you something about yourself as a human being. And I needed to play that role to really tap into my my power in a way, to not be afraid of my anger, to learn how to harness that, to use it for the better, to really own who I am and what makes me special and all of those things. You know, that's the stuff that, you know, everybody is always up against, but so it's really, like I said, it's always been about trying to be present and be not take things for granted and enjoy the moment, you know. But it's hard when you get more successful and meet more people are watching you and there's more scrutiny. And so the older I'm getting, the more that's kind of my journey and the stuff that I'm trying to get better at.
I got two girls at home, four and a six-year-old, and they love Frozen. And they could not care less for what I do. And then, but I think having a mate who met Elsa, is the biggest thing that I've ever been a part of.
This is your chance, buddy.
Yeah, this is it. I'm finally going to impress him.
Oh, that's very good. Hey, before we go, Idina Menzel's brand new disco pop album is called Drama Queen. It's out everywhere tomorrow, August the 18th. It's also available for pre-order right now.